Dear Mr. Prime Minister, Your Excellencies, Ministers, Honorable Chargé d'Affaires, AmCham fans, and fellow guests. 4 years ago, I was encouraged to get engaged. I was driving down the M7 highway and my phone rang. And I picked the phone up and it was the commercial attaché of the U.S. Embassy, and he encouraged me to run for the board of AmCham. It was late October. I didn't have a lot of time. In fact, I had no time to make the decision, which I'm actually happy for, because had I had time, I would have referred to things like I'm busy, I don't want to do it. But not having time, I said what I think anyone would have said on the M7, driving well under the speed limit, is yes. And I'm so thankful today that I said yes, because it gave me the opportunity to have insight into one of the most wonderful unfolding histories of the past 25 years. An unfolding history based on what I call E squared. Encourage and engage. 25 years ago, a quarter century ago, when GE first came to Hungary, just to give you a little perspective on it, the AmCham business breakfast in 1990 in the Forum Hotel cost 400 forints. GE thought big, acted as one, and moved with speed and set an example. And others started to follow the example. And in a short amount of time, the U.S. Embassy, who was absolutely pivotal in helping drive FDI investment into Hungary, was inundated with requests, and they reached out to a gentleman by the name of Michael Shade, who unfortunately cannot be with us today, but sent a very touching letter. He was the first president of AmCham. And they reached out to him and they said, can you help us? And so he pulled out his magic wand and got in contact with several people, and the idea of AmCham was born. But it was only an idea. A good idea, but only an idea. And then as time passed and people got involved, they got engaged. And as the engagement took off, which is a wonderful word, much better than involved, because engage means so much more. Involve means you show up. Engage means you take your heart to the meeting. Last week I was in Dublin. I attended a Web Summit conference. And I had the opportunity to speak with a lot of young kids, entrepreneurs, several from Hungary. And the one attribute that they all displayed was their desire to get engaged and make a difference. Powerful, you bet. It's E squared, the fuel of dreams. It was magnificent. I saw a movie not long ago. It was about how to start a movement. Don't worry, I'm not here tonight to educate you on how to start a movement. But what is very interesting, when they studied the process, they realized that it's not as much the leader as the first person who follows who makes a dramatic difference in where that movement goes. And this is where AmCham was brilliant in how it reached out and engaged people and showed them how to join. Several of those people who have been involved are here today. And I owe each and every one of you a heartfelt, personal thanks. You can absolutely be proud of that seed you planted. The momentum AmCham enjoys today is your momentum. And if you don't make those efforts years ago, then we're probably not celebrating this historic moment in this historic location. And so I'm encouraged when I look forward. In fact, it actually reminds me of an interesting story I heard not long ago. And certainly I'm not interested in trying to offend anyone, but I thought it was a cute story. There's a gentleman who's been married for 60 years from the state of Alabama. And he's in front of a large group like this, and they're asking about his relationship with his wife. And he says, for the 25th anniversary, I took my wife to Beijing, China. And everybody jumps to their feet and they're clapping and screaming and howling. And when the roar dies down, they ask him, what did you do for the 50th anniversary? And he said, I went back to China and got her. Unlike our friend from Alabama, that is certainly not our intention, is to leave people out. We can co-create our future. And as we stand on the edge of the next 25 years, knowing that our decisions today can affect every single tomorrow. That decision 25 years ago touched my life, but it touched yours also, as that is the common thread that causes us to unite this evening. There's a lot of hard work ahead, more encouraging and more engaging. And our CEO will be up here to share with us about the future, our future. But armed with the skills and the drive of our membership organizations, with freshly inked strategic relationships with the government and our determination, I am absolutely convinced that AmCham is poised to facilitate change in the future. It's a wonderful place to be. In 1990, the first AmCham newsletter appeared. And in it, there was an interview with then Dr. Ferenc Mádl, who ultimately ended up becoming the president. And in that interview, he closes with the following remarks. Come to Hungary, stay in Hungary. There is magic in those words. There is magic in encouraging and being encouraged. There is magic in engaging and being engaged. And there is magic in dreaming where we can be in 2039. President Mádl, if you can hear me now, we came to Hungary, we were encouraged, we were engaged, and we stayed. Thank you.